everyone, welcome to Master to Teach step-by-step guide. In this video, you will learn creating an EC2 instance in AWS, installing Ubuntu server, Apache, MySQL, and PHP. Finally, we will set up WordPress in EC2 instance. I will try my best to explain step-by-step. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please click on the subscribe button and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Let's start. Creating an EC2 instance in AWS. Open the AWS console page. Search for the EC2 instance, click and open it. Navigate to Instance menu, where you can see the list of instances that are created before. We are creating a new EC2 instance where we will set up the WordPress site. Click in Launch Instance. Now, step was choosing AMI. You can see the list of different kinds of servers available in AWS. Choose the server as per your requirement. For now, we are going to set up Ubuntu server 16.04 LTS. After selecting the operating system, the second step is choose the instance type. Choose the CPU and memory capacity as per your requirement. For this demo, let's choose 1 core CPU and 1 GB RAM. Next, third step, configure instance details. It's all about setting the network and roles. For now, we are going to skip it and going through the default setup. Another step is adding storage, which means the capacity of the hard drive. For setting up the WordPress site, 15 GB will be sufficient for now. We have option to choose the drive type like SSD or magnetic. SSD is faster and expensive than magnetic. For this demo purpose, let's go with SSD. Next, tag. Tags are used to identify the project or instance, as well as billing report, which can also generate according to tags, like username, master to teach. Next is configuring the security group, which means firewalls in the cloud computing. How can you allow to access the server? Like through SSH using TCP protocol in port number 22, allow from anywhere. Let's add HTTP as well, cause the user will request to access our site using HTTP protocol. Through HTTP using TCP protocol in port number 80 can access from anywhere in the world. Last step, review instance launch. We select the Ubuntu server as an operating system which contains 1 core CPU and 1 GB RAM. In the security group, we allow to access our server through this port. All instance details listed here. Storage of 15 GB SSD drive. Also, we placed a tag. Click in the launch instance. Now, we need to generate the key pair which is used to access the server as a password. The private key is stored in the server, whereas we download the public key. Create a new key pair. Name the key pair. We are going through WordPress, so let's name it as WordPress. And download the key pair wordpress.pem. Now, launch the instance. Okay, instance is running now. Now, the second step is installing Apache, MySQL, and PHP. Open the terminal. For all guidance, select the instance and click Connect button, where you can see all details step by step to connect the server. Let's follow step by step. Open an SSH client, which is our terminal for us. Locate your private key files, it's in my download folder. The third one, your key must not be publicly viewable for SSH to work. Let's check the permission for now. Admin can rewrite, the group can read it, through the network can read it. We have to change the permission, for which here is the command for us. Copy it and paste it to run. This command will remove the read permission for others, and even admin can't change the file. Let's check it. Okay, now only I can read this file, other can't. Okay, moving to the fourth one, connect to your instance using its public DNS. Either you can just copy it and paste it to connect the server, or SSH -i wordpress.pim, Ubuntu @ IP address. Connecting through SSH, private key act as a password. Ubuntu has default username as Ubuntu. @ public IP, we can use public DNS as well. Sure to connect, yes. Now you can see we are inside the Ubuntu server, connected successfully. So far up to now, we set up our Ubuntu server in our AWS cloud. We ran the server. We connect the server using the terminal through SSH. Now we are going to install Apache for the web server so that we can run the PHP code. Update server, sudo apt-get update. Install Apache, sudo apt-get install Apache 2. Are you sure? Yeah. Okay, successfully installed the Apache in the server. Now let's install the MySQL server as well. Sudo apt-get install MySQL-server. Are you sure? Yes. Okay, need to set up a password of the MySQL. Here default username is root. For now, let's set root as a password, which is not a good password, but for demo, I am using it. Repeat the password. Okay, successfully installed MySQL as well. One more thing to install in the server, that is PHP. Let's install the PHP including some libraries. Sudo apt-get install php lib apache 2 mode php php mcrypt php mysql. php mysql is library file which helps to connect to MySQL. We have successfully installed the PHP as well. Let's restart the Apache server. Sudo service apache 2 restart. Now let's move to place a few PHP code. For that, we need to access the HTML folder. cd var www/HTML, which is located at var www.html. Now let's create a new PHP file in the server. Sudo nano test.php. Open the text editor, write the PHP code. For now, I am going to place PHP info, which is a library function which gives all the details about the installed PHP. Press Ctrl plus O to write out and press Ctrl plus X to exit. We can view the file content using command cat test.php. Let's view the page in the browser. Here you can see the file. Click on it. Here are all details about the PHP that we have installed on the server. In this way, we can set up our Ubuntu server in the AWS cloud and install Apache, MySQL and PHP to run the PHP and MySQL on the server. Now let's move to WordPress. We can download the WordPress setup files from wordpress.org. We need to upload the setup files in the server, for which we can upload in different ways, like upload from the command line or enabling FTP, or we can directly download the setup files in the server from terminal. Copy the setup file link address. Sudo wget and paste the link. List the file. Here it downloads the zip file. Now let's unzip the file. The program unzip is currently not installed. You can install it by typing sudo apt install unzip. Let's install it as well. Just copy and paste to install. Okay, now let's unzip the zip file. Sudo unzip latest.zip. List. Here is a WordPress folder that contains WordPress setup files. Now let's check the site in the browser. Here it goes. Now we can install the WordPress. Let's start. Here we need to create the database first. Let's go for it. In terminal, MySQL dash u root as a username dash p and enter. It will ask for the password root as a password. Now I am in MySQL server where we can use the SQL query to use MySQL. Like so database. For now we need to create a new database. Create database. Database name master to teach underscore db. So database. Here is our new database. Now moving back to the browser, database name master to teach underscore db, username root, password root, database host. We are on the same server, so the local host is fine. If you are using RDS for the database, we need to place the host URL which is provided by RDS while configuring the RDS database. You can learn from my previous video tutorial, Amazon RDS. Table prefix for now, m2t underscore. Unable to write to the wp-config.php file, which is due to no permission. We can set the permission or we can just copy this code and make a wp-config.php file in the WordPress folder. Let's exit from the MySQL first. Exit. Navigate to WordPress folder, cd WordPress. Sudo nano wp-config.php. Paste the code here and save it. Same as before. Press Ctrl plus O to write out and press Ctrl plus X to exit. List. Here is the wp-config.php file. Moving forward, run the installation. Give a site name. Site admin username admin, site admin password m@str2tacs, email master2teach@gmail.com. Successfully installed the WordPress site. Let's log in to the admin panel. Admin master2teach. Let's view the front end. In this way, you can host a WordPress site in your own configuration in AWS. At last, one more thing. Due to permission, you may face the issues like while installing a new theme in WordPress, it will ask for the details. So let's configure the permission of the WordPress folder. Sudo change ownership chown www-data:www-data. Adding this folder in Apache www-data group dash r, which is recursive ownership, and folder location var www.html WordPress. Sudo chown www-data:www-data-r var www /html/wordpress. Now, let's try to install the theme. Okay, great, it's working fine now. Now, let's check for the plugin. Okay, great, it's working fine as well. One more issue you can face in the site while changing the param link settings to post name. It's showing the not found issue. For this solution, you have to enable the read-write mode in the Apache server. Sudo a2en mode rewrite. Sudo apache2 enable mode read-write. Let's restart the server. Sudo service apache2 restart. Let's check the site. Still not working. It may be due to allowing override none. Let's change the allow override to all in the Apache configuration file. Sudo nano /etc/apache2/apache2.config. Let's search for the word Ctrl+W var www. Here it is. We need to modify allow override none to allow override all. Save it as before, Ctrl+O, Ctrl+X. Again, restart the server, sudo service apache2 restart. Let's check it in the browser. Refresh. Okay, here it works. Now you can install the theme, plugin, create the post and pages as per your requirements and host the WordPress site in AWS by yourself with your own configured server. I hope you learned from this video tutorial. If you have any questions or comments, please make sure to leave a comment in the comment section below. Also, please be sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Thank you very much for watching. Check us out for more in IT tutorial and guide on website mastertoteach.com, and we will see you again soon. Bye.